Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture. In this module, we will discuss the need of standard units of measurement. Let's start by asking a simple question. How long you will take to finish the work? For answering this question, you need to measure the accurate time. When does the passenger train arrive at Sonipat station? For answering this question, you also need to measure the accurate time. What may happen if you get late to the railway station? You may miss the train. To reach the railway station in time, you need to measure the time. What you may lose if you are late for a job interview? You may miss the opportunity of getting job. To get the job, you must know the accurate time and to attend the interview. You might have observed, for answering all these questions, you need to measure the accurate time. It means the measurement of accurate time is very necessary in our day-to-day life. Otherwise, we will miss many opportunities and we will not be able to do any work in time. In earlier times, people used the events or the phenomena which repeated after a fixed interval of time to measure the time. For example, the time interval between sunrise or sunset or to the next sunrise, from one full moon to another full moon, from one season to another season. These time intervals cannot be taken as standard units of measurement, because these are very long time intervals and changes from place to place and time to time. In earlier times, the people were using sundial, sand clock, water clock. These clocks were used in ancient times to measure the time. But these are not standard units of measurement. Sundial. It was used to measure the time. It was based on the fact that length of the shadow cast by an object changes with the time of the day. As the sun moves, length of the shadow changes and it gives the time according to that shadow. Sand clock. It consists of two bulbs that are connected vertically with each other through a narrow neck, which allows the sand to pass from one bulb to another in a regulated manner. This clock was also not appropriate. Simple pendulum. It was devised by Huygens in 1658. He actually used the pendulum to regulate the movement in clocks. It consists of a small metallic bulb that is of blue color, you can see here, suspended by a thread from a rigid spoke. It moves to and fro after a fixed interval of time, and this phenomena was used to make pendulum clock. You can see the equilibrium point. This is known as the main position, or you can say original position. And maxima, you know, the maximum displacement by the bob on either side of the main position. And mean position is known as equilibrium position, and extreme position, the positions where the bob is at the maximum position from the mean position, and amplitude, the maximum displacement of the bob from its mean position is called amplitude of pendulum. Time period, time taken by the bob of the pendulum to complete one oscillation is called time period, and frequency is the number of oscillations made by pendulum in 1 second is known as frequency. Let's calculate time period of the pendulum. Suppose a simple pendulum takes 32 seconds to complete 20 oscillations. Then what is the time period of the pendulum? Time period of the pendulum will be calculated by total time taken to the number of oscillations. Means total time taken is 32 seconds and number of oscillations are 20. So we will divide 32 by 20. It will be 1.6 seconds. Now, measurement of length. In earlier times, people used to measure the length by cubit, arm span, etc. Cubit, it is the length between the tip of the middle finger and elbow of the outstretched arm. And 1 cubit is equal to 18 inches. Arm span, it is the length between the outstretched arm. This arrow of red color showing length of the outstretched arm, and this is the distance shown by arm span. A footstep, it is the length between the tip of the big toe and the heel. Next, hand span. It was used in ancient times generally. It is the length between the tip of the thumb and the little finger of an outstretched palm. A pace. It is the length covered in a single step while walking. These units were used in ancient time, but these are not the standard units of measurement. These are not uniform. It changes from person to person. In order to bring uniformity in the system of measurements, a more uniform system of measurement called International System of Units was developed, and it is written as SI unit. SI unit of length is meter and time is second. Speed is meter per second and SI unit of mass is kilogram. Thank you and have a nice day.